Did you guys know some air filters for your motorcycle will come with a 1,000,000-mile warranty? I'm Adrian from YouMotorcycle. Today's video, we're going to talk about everything you need to know about motorcycle air filters. What they do, how different filters work differently from one another, why a generic air filter costs half the price of a K&N one, and which filter is actually best for your motorcycle. So what exactly does an air filter do? Well, your air filter has two main jobs. The first one is to give your air motorcycle the air it needs for combustion so you can start riding. And the second one is to filter out all the bad particles in the air to help keep your motor running at full power without breaking down for as long as possible. Think of your motorcycle's engine kind of like an air compressor. The more air you can get to it, the more power it can put to the back wheel. So does that mean we should just get rid of the old, dirty, locked up air filter and run with no filter? I mean, it sounds like more air equals more good and less obstruction equals more air, so no filter equals more good, right? Theoretically, 100%, that does make sense in theory, but in reality, not at all. Sure, more air does equal more good, but more clean air equals more good. See, clean air burns better than air full of dirt and other pollutants. Clean air leads to better and more complete combustion, which means more motorcycle performance, literally giving you more bang for your buck. And of course, there's another side benefit too. All of that dirt and pollutants that are in the air, they can actually get into your motor and wear it out prematurely if you don't have an air filter. So the air filter definitely has a job to do, and you're going to want to make sure you're getting as much clean air, not just air, as possible into your bike. So how do different air filters work? Well, there are three different main types of air filters, and they all work a little bit differently to juggle the exact same job, which is get as much airflow in as we can, while at the same time blocking out as many pollutants. Basically, we've got one filter for your vehicle with two different sets of competing responsibilities that are at odds with each other, and three different approaches to how we handle the problem.
The first motorcycle air filter you encounter is a paper air filter. These are typically what come OEM in your motorcycle. These guys do a really good job of filtering air because they have really tiny pores inside of them. The flip side is they're poor at allowing filtered air to get into your motor. Because they filter so much, the paper air filters can get dirty sooner, taking away from your motorcycle's performance. The next air filter type is the oiled foam air filter. Honestly, I use one of these on my Vespa. The foam is oiled, which can help trap pollutants through the air, and the foam can hold dirt for a long time while still allowing clean air to pass through it without much restriction. Another reason why I like these and I use them in my Vespa's airbox is because Vespas have a tendency of getting knocked over. Seriously, this is a problem in the city. People back into Vespas all the time, they get knocked over, and Vespas are known for pouring a bunch of oil into the airbox, thereby flooding your filter. If you have a paper filter, once your filter is soaked, your Vespa won't start. You can't give chase to the offender and get their insurance info. But these foam filters, these things can get soaked and your bike can still run. So if you have something that might get knocked over, or if you live in places that might be prone to being more wet, or you have a bike that's just prone to being on its side, foam filter might be the way to go. So the third and final filter we'll be looking at is the oiled cotton gauze filter, aka the K&N filter. This is typically what I put on any of my more serious performance vehicles. So I'll use it on my truck, I'll use it on my V-Rod. Basically anything where I wanna have more serious power and a little bit better throttle response, I'm putting a K&N filter in it. Essentially the oil catches and traps air pollutants, which allows it to hold a ton of dirt while still allowing maximum airflow possible. Meaning it'll help with performance over your paper air filter, while at the same time still not compromising the air purity entering your motorcycle. Honestly, one of my favorite things about the K&Ns is that you grab one of these packs, it's the K&N rechargers, and that makes this thing last basically the lifetime of your vehicle. I think the warranty on these is like 1,000,000 miles or something ridiculous. Essentially how it works, you open up the pack, comes with a cleaner bottle. You take the cleaner, you spray the heck out of this, apply it, just let it soak. Then once it's all wet, let it soak for 10 minutes. It's gonna loosen up all the particles and stuff that get into the filter. Let it soak for a bit. You come back to it, and you rinse it. Now make sure you rinse it whichever way the wind goes through. If the air goes this way, you rinse it this way, wash all the dirty stuff out, not in. Then you just let it sit, you wait, let it dry, go have yourself a beer, whatever you want. You get the oil and you oil in between the seams. Let that sit for a bit, pop it back in your motorcycle or whatever vehicle you're using it on, and you're good to go.
So of course, now you're probably thinking, is the K&N filter actually worth it? It's twice the price of the boring old paper air filter. But if you're like me, you've bought two to shoot a YouTube video and you gotta figure out which one you're gonna keep and which one you're gonna throw out. So let me answer this question. Seriously though, before I answer which one you should buy between a K&N or a paper filter, if you are liking this video, please do me a favor, give me a big thumbs up. It helps the algorithm know this is a quality video that other people might want to watch. I would really appreciate your support. And if you want to see more videos with me basically just answering motorcyclist questions, please hit subscribe. Okay, on with the show. All right, so listen, if all you want is just the normal filter that came with your motorcycle from factory that it was designed for, that you can use and not worry about and throw away and buy a new one the way consumerism intended, by all means, use that paper air filter. I get it. It's the vanilla of air filters, but some people like that safe, familiar feeling, so go vanilla, whatever. But if you want something that's a little bit more fun, if you want something that will last the rest of your vehicle's lifespan, that could potentially add a little bit of added performance, K&N gives this thing a 10-year warranty or like a 1,000,000-mile warranty. It's ridiculous. Whether you're gonna get one of these because you do want a little bit more power or you want to try something different, or maybe you're an environmentalist who doesn't like the idea of using something, throwing it out, this is a good option. Or if you're like me and you're not necessarily an environmentalist, but you just want to get a little bit more bang for your buck, I like these a lot. Does it cost literally twice as much as the paper filter I just threw over there? Yes, but this more than pays for itself. Can you go wrong getting the paper filter? No, not at all. Just be mindful that the requirements manufacturers have and your own personal requirements might be different. So they might be making stuff lean or super clean to help pass emissions. Maybe you care about that, but maybe you'd rather have a little bit more fun. It's up to you. And I think that ties in really well to the last question I want to answer, which is what filter is actually best for your motorcycle? I mean, we know that the filter's job is to get as much air in and keep as much crap out. So which one's actually going to be best for your particular bike? Truthfully, that's going to come down on application. I'm not the biggest fan of paper filters. I will use them on some of my more low-powered machines where I don't really care about performance. They're totally fine if that's what you want. If you want to feel comfortable having your vehicle completely stock, by all means, that's the right option for you. Me, on my more fun vehicles or on my work vehicle, I like having the K&N. I do get a little bit better response. I don't know if it's psychological or not. People have done dyno tests, though, so you can actually look up dyno test on Google. Your motorcycle model, and you'll see charts that show the different increase in performance. So it's cool to check out. You can actually see results on paper, which is neat. So if that's your jam, K&N or the cotton gauze oiled filters, definitely my recommendation. And truthfully, the vehicle that I ride probably the second most is my little Vespa. I love that thing, and I use the foam filter on that. I absolutely love it. It does help to get more air flowing through. You will notice it on such a small motor, the difference that it makes, having a not-so-restricted air intake. You can feel a difference. Depending on what your application is, if your bike might be getting knocked over a lot, that might be a good setup for you too. All right, guys, if you like this video, please support me by hitting the like button. I would really appreciate that. If you want to see more videos by me answering your questions, or feel free to leave me a question down below, hit the subscribe button. I will answer you. Thank you guys for your support. I appreciate it. As always, ride safe, but have fun. Peace.